Hello everybody. My name is เฉลิมรัตน์นนทภา I am a student from Department Mathematics and Statistics, Faculty of Science and Technology, Thammasat University. Today, I would like to present my research with my advisor about the topic of forecasting diesel consumption in Thailand using decomposition with Sarimac ANN hybrid model. First of all, I would like to introduce about the state of problem. In Thailand, even if the fuel consumption is increasing rapidly and the country has been affected by the high volatility of crude oil price, so for 2020 to 2022, primary energy consumption was declined by 4.9%. You can see the figure one as the proportion of energy consumption that the second sector is oil consumption is 29.4%. For the next diesel consumption in Thailand, the average growth rate is 3.21% per year as shown in the figure 2. And you can see the figure 3 is the highest sector is diesel consumption is 53%. So this is how to we know in the future of the diesel consumption. This research objective is to study and compare the five models such that ANN, Sarima, Sarimac, Dexilimac and Dexilimac NN. And the second is to study the factor that affect to the diesel consumption in Thailand. And to select the best model to use, this model to forecast to the future is 2021 and 2022. For the theory, we have the second model. The first is the single as shown in NN, Sarima, Sarimac, Dexilimac. And the second one is hybrid model is the Dexilimac NN. So in ANN is the computing algorithm to solve the problem as you can see the T component of ANN is the input hidden and the output layer that shown the relation in equation 1. So for the second is the decomposition method is the separate model that can separate the correlation, for example 10 seasonal cycle and auricula as shown in the multiplicative and additive in this equation 2 and 3. So the next is the seasonal auto-regressive integrated moving average of Sarima. This is the extension model of Arima that you can see the seasonal term in equation 4 and 5. So the next is seasonal auto-regressive integrated moving average with the exogenous variable. This is the Sarimac model is the extension term of Sarima with the X factor exogenous variable X. As you can see the relation of regression between Y and X in equation 6 and we get the Sarimac model in equation 8. So for number 5, this is the decomposition with Sarimac is applied to estimate 10 cycle auricula component by with use the 10 component in multiplicative decomposition as you can see in equation 10. The last model is hybrid model. So the hybrid model is look at the data by two parts as linear and nonlinear component as you can see equation 11. So the forecasting from linear model that use decomposition with Sarimac and the nonlinear you get by earlier term and you construct the nonlinear and find the hybrid forecasting in linear and nonlinear component. For model evaluation criteria, we have two criteria is MAPE as equation 12 and IER as shown in equation 30. So research methodology for diesel consumption dataset, we have variable Y is the diesel consumption and with the exogenous X1 to XA as shown in the right hand side. So the figure in the left hand side is the time sequence of the diesel consumption dataset that separate two parts. The first part is training dataset. This is the January 2000 to December of 2019. This is the training dataset and the testing set is January 2020 to 2021. So we have the modeling idea in the chart that can show the idea of a modeling linear component when we want to use to approximate the linear component by Dexilimac. And the model of nonlinear part in this picture show construct the nonlinear part by ANN. For the experiment result, the result show that decomposition with Sarimac model and ANN is the best model that used to forecast the diesel consumption in Thailand. So you can see the optimal model in the black box. So we have the R square 99.875%. So the first one is linear component as you can see, and the second one is nonlinear component as you can see the overall model in the red box. For the next, when we want to use this model, you can find the seasonal index in the left hand side of a table 1 that you can see that the effective in March is effective from the seasonal variation 9%. And the table 2 is you want to estimate the dexlimax. So you can get the parameter estimate C in the table 2. For figure 6, you can see the forecast value and the actual value in blue line, the forecast value in red line. Let's compare between the hybrid model and the real data set, which have the MAPE for 12 months and 24 months and are spare in here. So model for the performance of model, as you can see in table 3. So for MAPE training and 12 months, 24 months, you can see that dexlimax NN is the lowest MAPE. This means that the hybrid model between dexlimax NN is the best model that we can use to forecast the diesel consumption. And the left hand side is figure 7 that show the bar chart that dexlimax NN is the lowest MAPE. And the right hand side is IER for 12 months and 24 months. When we compare the hybrid model with the Salima model, you can see the yellow and red bar chart is the higher than Salima model. So when we compare the real value of forecasting between 24 months the time forecasting with the real monthly in the table 4 and in the figure 9, we can see the effect of the COVID-19 pandemic of Thailand that affect about the diesel consumption and the effect about the forecast value of the hybrid model look same in the phase 1 and phase 2 and phase 3 again. So Table 5 show the absolute percentage error of 24 months lead time forecasting. We have the equation that why we use the hybrid model, because when we see the MAPE in table 3 is sometimes is not different, but in figure 10 show that the absolute percentage error for 24 months lead time forecasting for the dexlimax NN is close to zero. This means that the hybrid model is the best way to use forecast diesel consumption than another single model. So conclusion, we see that the hybrid model dexlimax model is high performance and keep the low weight MAPE for 12 months and 24 months. And the second is in the hybrid model is the high efficiency of IER for 12 months and 24 months again. This shows that the hybrid model is an effective way to improve more accurate forecasting than a single model. So for the next future research, we can try to approximate 10 in exponential and whole winter. And we can use the nonlinear path as the family of neural networks, such as LSTM and INN or GRU. So we can apply this idea to the big data set. So I want to tell about the benefit of research. First, the forecast value from the hybrid model is used to forecast diesel consumption in Thailand in 2022. As you can see in the table 6. For the right hand side, total diesel consumption in this year is effect to the land transportation. The sector of land transportation is the highest sector, is 86%. So for the second, we planning the cost of land transportation based on the minimum and the maximum price diesel in Thailand. As you can see in the figure 12. The figure 12 show that the total cost of diesel consumer classified by the type of diesel. So we calculate by using the period type of diesel allowed 5 January to the 16 February. So the right hand side is figure 13, is the classified consumption by type of diesel fuel that you can see the highest sector is diesel B7 and B10, B20 and the premium respectively. For the third market share of oil company selling diesel in 2022, you can see the bar chart of PTT is the highest market share for 41%. So as you can see, the another company in figure 14. So the last, this research suggests to the government that planning model for BCG economic system and the sustainability, that in the future, we want to reduce the air pollution and get more the clean energy. That's we try to have the new station of energy station of all Thailand. So in the future, we have the number of increasing car that have the electrical energy. So acknowledgement, we want to thank Professor Dr. Ajun An from York University and our Department of Mathematics and Statistics from Thammasat University. And for the open source data, we want to thank the Department of Energy Policy Planning and Department of Energy Business. So this is the reference. Thank you for your attention.